CSS Grid offers a powerful and flexible way to design page layouts. One of its key features is the ability to automatically adjust the size of grid cells and wrap them onto the next row when needed. This is done by combining the magic of the repeat function with the autofill and autofit keywords. In this video, we will dive into the difference between autofill and autofit and how to use them to create dynamic and responsive layouts without using any media queries. Make sure to subscribe and ring the notification bell if you haven't already. This is Optimistic Web, where we explore the world of CSS and front-end development, one step at a time. The markup is simple. We have two wrappers and a bunch of cards inside each. The HTML structure in both cases is similar, except for a CSS class. The first one uses grid autofill, while the second one has grid autofit. In the CSS, the cards class is set as a grid container with 5 columns of 100 pixels each. Then there is some basic styling just for the presentation. And this is what the page looks like. 2 sections of cards, both looking identical in terms of size and placement. But there's a significant issue with this grid setup. On small screen devices, the columns don't wrap when the viewport becomes narrow to fit them all, causing a scroll bar. And on larger screens, we end up with a lot of unused space that could be used more effectively. Let's see how we can improve our CSS so that the grid responds to the available space and automatically adjusts the grid cells. First of all, we can use the repeat function to define the grid columns. It takes 2 arguments, the repeat count and the track size. Since all 5 columns in the grid are 100 pixels wide, the first argument will be 5, and the second one will be 100 pixels. While this does improve the code, the problem is still there. The grid still overflows on small screens. The next thing we can do is replace the 100 pixels width with 1FR. This solves the overflow issue and removes the scroll bar, but the cards become too small. It can be hard to read the content on smaller devices, while on large screens, the cards look oversized because they don't have any maximum limit. That's where the min-max function comes in. It takes 2 values, a minimum and a maximum. In our case, we set the minimum size to 100 pixels and the maximum to 1FR. The code is getting better and better, but the core issue remains. It still overflows on small screens and becomes oversized on larger ones. The problem is that we are explicitly telling the browser to add 5 columns per row. But what if we could allow the browser to repeat as many columns as they can fit in a row, then wrap the rest of them onto the next row? This is where the autofill and autofit keywords bring their magic. Let's first go through the autofill and hide the second group of cards for the time being. We can replace the first argument of the repeat function with autofill, and with this small update, the layout is changed significantly. Now the cards automatically wrap when there isn't enough space, and on larger screens, they no longer become oversized. Let's inspect the code in the DevTools to understand what's happening behind the scenes. Although we have only 5 cards in our HTML, if you look at the grid layout carefully, you will notice a total of 7 columns. Since there was extra space available, the browser added 2 empty cells at the end. But why 2 empty cells and not 3 or 4? Let's verify this again. The grid container shows a width of 721 pixels, and with the minimum column size set to 100 pixels, at least 7 columns can fit in a single row, leaving a leftover space of 21 pixels. This extra space is distributed equally among all columns, including the empty ones. The autofill keyword tells the browser to fill the row with as many columns as it can fit. So it creates implicit columns if there's enough space to add more. These added columns might be empty, but they still occupy their space in the row. Now let's bring the second set of cards back into play and try this with the autofit keyword. Notice the difference? The min-max declaration is exactly the same, but the column sizes look quite different. The autofit behaves similarly to autofill, but it distributes the extra space among the existing columns. Like autofill, it adds empty columns if space allows, but those empty columns collapse, so they don't take up any space in the grid. Instead, the leftover space is distributed across the existing columns. Let's double-check this in the Dev Tools. We have explicitly defined 5 columns in our HTML, and with the autofill setting, 2 empty cells have been added to the first group. If we check the column line numbers, it ends at number 8, which confirms that the grid has a total of 7 columns. When we check the line numbers of the second grid, it has a similar pattern of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then jumps to 8. This shows that autofit also adds empty columns, but these empty cells don't occupy any space, and the leftover space is distributed among the existing ones. In simple words, autofill and autofit both function similarly. They both create implicit columns when there's enough space to add more. With autofill, even if the newly added columns are empty, they still take up designated space in the row, and any leftover space is distributed among all columns, including the empty ones. On the other hand, with autofit, the newly added columns collapse and don't occupy any space. Instead, the leftover space is distributed among the columns that already exist. Both methods provide a convenient way to create layouts that adapt to various screen sizes and content variations without relying on media queries. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more. Feel free to leave your questions or comments below. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.